The cell cycle is regulated. The ability of a cell to progress from one phase of the cell cycle to the next is under control. It's not predestined. Entering a new cycle or a new phase of the cycle requires that the previous phase be completed in good order. This is one first clue that there are factors produced in the cytoplasm of cells responsible for controlling whether or not a cell goes into the next phase. So here we have cells in G1 and cells in the S phase, eukaryotic cells showing their nuclei, different colors, right? We're going to fuse them. We've seen cell fusion before, so we're going to fuse them with polyethylene glycol or some other trick that we can get cells to join like this. We're going to add tritiated thymine to the fused cells. After a short period of time, we're going to spread those cells on a slide and we're going to make autoradiographs. What people saw was that both nuclei contain newly synthesized DNA, meaning both nuclei underwent replication. Now, you would expect that to happen in the blue nucleus, which was from a cell that was already in the S phase. You would not expect that to be true of a cell in G1, which is prior to the S phase. And yet, the G1 nucleus is making DNA. So you would conclude from this kind of experiment that there must be some factor, there must be some regulatory molecule, assume that it's a protein, and you would be correct. There must be some S phase protein factor responsible for causing or inducing the nucleus of the G1 cell to start replicating its DNA prematurely, that is, before it has reached the appropriate time to do so. The regulation of progress through the cell cycle occurs at several specific times during the cycle, which we call checkpoints. You will see that the cell cycle is regulated just prior, for example, to entering mitosis. It is regulated just prior to entering the S phase, the DNA synthesis phase, and so on. And these checkpoints or regulatory points are there to ensure that the cell has completed the previous phase without untoward incident. We're going to see that the factors that regulate the cell cycle at these checkpoints are largely protein kinases. Many events in the life of a cell at any time are regulated by the phosphorylation or dephosphorylation of proteins, enzymes, chromatin proteins, and so on. Well, it is protein kinases which catalyze the phosphorylation of proteins that control cell cycle events, that are the watchdogs of whether a cell will go into the next phase or not. We will look at how cells exit the cell cycle. As you may recall, most mature cells in your body, most terminally differentiated cells in your body, no longer divide. Notably, your nerve cells don't divide, but your blood cells don't divide. Liver cells generally don't divide. What does divide and thereby replace aging cells are, of course, adult stem cells. So for most tissues in your body, you have a source of stem cells that replenishes those mature cells, which have a finite lifetime. A perfect example is your bone marrow, which is the source of stem cells that produce white blood cells and erythrocytes, red blood cells. Those red blood cells and white blood cells themselves don't replicate. They are mature cells. And then, of course, all of the cells of tissues and organs that are fully differentiated also don't divide and are replaced by stem cells. Just a second ago, I said that cells die. They have to be replaced. They don't live forever. But what happens when they die? They undergo something called apoptosis. That is a term that describes programmed cell death. We will talk a little bit about apoptosis. We know something about what controls apoptosis. A good example, by the way, of apoptosis would be the tadpole that metamorphoses into a frog. You know that the tadpole grows new limbs and it grows genitalia, gonads. What it loses is its tail. Well, the tail doesn't just fall off and then decay in the water. The cells of the tadpole tail undergo apoptosis, and the result is that the components are recycled. Proteins are broken down to amino acids. DNA is broken down to nucleotides and bases. RNA is broken down into nucleotides and bases. All of the cell macromolecules are hydrolyzed and the component monomers recycled to make a grown-up frog. That is the function of controlling programmed cell death. When cells die because they have been wounded, neglected, if you will, we say that they've undergone necrosis.